Hi, I'm David Hiff here on Conestoga Hockey Talk with Ryan Drury, week 5. And a lot of important things to talk about today. First of all, we're going to talk about the Tampa Bay and Philly incident last Thursday. The 1-3-1 situation that Tampa Bay was playing against Philly made it really hard to break out. But we're going to show you guys on the big board. We named it Big Bongzo. So introduce her.
Let's wheel out Bongzo, boys.
There's Bongzo.
Here we are, Big Bongzo. All right. So, Philly-Tampa game, Thursday. A lot of things went wrong. It was an atrociously boring game to watch. Here's exactly what went wrong.
Wayne Simmonds for the Flyers drops it back. Emo Timonen slides it across.
Already changing on the fly. Tampa Bay, Dominic Moore, red zone, Dave. Wasn't sure what to do because he was expecting a different matchup. This is right out of the Washington Capitals playbook from last year in the playoffs. The 1-3-1, you see the one player up, red zone three across. Philadelphia's prepared, they're taking their time.
Yeah, look at this. I mean, they're just going to stay back there.
And look at this. Rier just said to St. Louis, you better go forecheck him because we're not going to move.
Tampa Bay, they're playing the 1-3-1 trap. It's been used for a long time. What went wrong here? Philadelphia's in their own zone. They don't want to play the 1-3-1 trap. They're laying back. Chris Pronger sat right here and held the puck and just passed it back and forth between his defense partner down here. They wouldn't come up the ice. Philadelphia really relies on a board play breakout. They like to bring the rush up the boards and then push it through the neutral zone. That's not going to happen with Tampa Bay playing all the way across the neutral zone. That gives the 1-3-1 trap its strength. Who is at fault for this game? Well, both teams are a little at fault in my opinion. Philadelphia for not trying to move the puck and force Tampa Bay to chase them through the neutral zone. And also Tampa Bay, they had a forechecker right here who was Steve Stamkos for a large majority of the game. Steve Stamkos is a really fast skater. He did not pressure either of these Philadelphia defensemen at all. Tampa went into this game knowing that Philly loves the board play up the boards. Philly typically does not put pressure up straight through the middle. They like the board play, and the 1-3-1 kind of erased that. Philadelphia could either hung back and broke out all as a five-man unit straight up the ice, or they could have tried bringing Chris Pronger up the ice and trying to get this forechecker to tail off and break the 1-3-1 trap. Neither team would bite, neither team would move, and it made for a really, really slow-paced game. Dave, who do you feel is more at fault for this atrocity we saw on Thursday?
Well, I agree with you. I think that it was both teams at fault, but if I can use that marker for 1 second.
Absolutely.
Here. All right, well, the one thing that makes it the most difficult is that even if Philly does get the opportunity to get to the red line, which is very difficult because they're lined up, Tampa Bay is lined up right here, if Philly actually dumps that puck in, they have that one defenseman here that's going to beat that, win that race to the puck 99% of the time. And just an automatic breakout for Tampa the other way, and it's almost impossible for Philly to generate any offense. So in that respect, yes, I agree, it's really difficult for Philly, but at the same time, Tampa Bay needs to get a forechecker in there. So, you know what, that's basically our little segment, just trying to draw out and show you guys what happened this Thursday, and hope to see you back on Conestoga Hockey Talk.